7 days, and I'm still depleted from this past weekend. Oh, what was so wrong with my weekend? Asked no one ever. I was stuck in the nine rings of Hulu Hell-ary, and I've emerged battered and broken, with all of the lowly details about the deception that is the Clintons. I'm Katie Petrick, and this is Healthy Republic. Let's address the big narcissist in the room. Her name is Hillary Rodham Clinton. But before this, today's question is, if you made a documentary about Hillary, what would you call it? Hulu got creative. Okay, not really. On Friday, Hulu released Clinton's docuseries, Hillary. And before it even started, it had to give the "this is intended for a mature audience" warning, so I really shouldn't have watched it. But I did anyway, because I'm a rebel without a cause. Now, I don't want to punish you, so here's just a bit of the trailer.
As long as she has been in public light, there have been these ups and downs. You know, be our champion, go away.
You want to make a difference, you want to have an impact. Well then, you got to get in the arena.
Maybe I wanted to punish you a little. I watched the entire four-part series at more than 1 hour for each episode. That's more than 4 hours of my life that I have lost. Lost forever. Hillary can relate. USA Today published a video the day before the Hulu doc was released in which Hillary laid claim to the purpose.
I really felt like it was a great opportunity to have someone with the track record and talent that Nanette has to try to tell my whole story rather than bits and pieces and totally made up stuff that unfortunately has been all too common.
Well, that's a lie right there. Hillary called the making of the docuseries an incredibly intense experience. I guess reflecting on a life of lies, deceit, compartmentalizing, and greed will do that to a person. There were several things learned from watching this series, beginning with, number one, for all the complaints she has about Trump, Clinton fails to look in the mirror and know she's laying the same claims about herself.
What is this about? When people say I'm not authentic, what you see is what you get.
Like, I am the most investigated innocent person in America. And they just, you know, they are just, see, that's why this is not just politics. It's deep cultural stuff.
All these things about us get disproved. But the press, and I'm talking about the major organs of the press, not the Breitbarts and the, you know, InfoWars and the crazy people, they always bite.
My bluntness, my outspokenness, my pushback, all of that creates cognitive dissonance in people.
That's a pot calling the kettle black. Both Clinton and Trump can rally together when discussing the uselessness of Bernard Sanders and the danger of his supporters.
Honestly, Bernie just drove me crazy. He was in Congress for years, years. He had one senator support him. Nobody likes him. Nobody wants to work with him. He got nothing done. He was a career politician. He did not work till he was like 41, and then he got elected to something. It was all just baloney, and I feel so bad that, you know, people got sucked into it.
I worry that there's an underlying vitriol with some percentage of American supporters.
I agree with that.
Let's remember this gem from the 2016 campaign.
I am so sick of the Sanders campaign lying about me. I'm sick of it.
Bernard provided his review of the documentary, and it may have been two fingers up, but they are certainly not thumbs.
Unlike Secretary Clinton, I don't want to relive 2016. We're in 2020.
What a burn there, Bernie! Of the entire documentary, here's my favorite, as it involves President Clinton's impeachment.
I had done the research about what is a high crime or misdemeanor. I knew what the standards of impeachment were. I knew this did not meet it. You know, he shouldn't have done what he did. He shouldn't have tried to hide it, but it was not an impeachable offense.
This leads directly into the second thing I learned. Number two, it's still about Bill. Bill Clinton, the serial philanderer, and according to Juanita Broderick, the rapist Bill Clinton, made the audience feel pity for Hillary as to this day he tries to make it nonchalant about what he did and how it affected him.
It's you feel like you're staggering around and you've been in a 15-round prize fight that was extended to 30 rounds. And here's something to take your mind off it for a while. That's what happens.
Broderick had her own review of the documentary, saying Hulu owes an apology to survivors of sexual abuse, rape, and intimidation by the Clintons. Broderick alleged that Clinton raped her in 1978 when he was Attorney General of Arkansas. The Clintons deny all of it. The documentary revealed Bill Clinton's excuse for his affair is something to do to manage my anxieties, and cheating on his wife helped him take his mind off of the responsibilities of being president. That's our moral crumble of a society that continues on to this day. Okay, if you are stressed, go get a massage. Go play tennis. But you keep your damn pants on. You don't stick your genitals where they don't belong. Clinton said he has become a totally different person in the last 20 years. So there's that. Also involving Bill, I learned that Hillary said no the first time Bill proposed marriage. If only she would have walked away then. And that's the final point. Number three, she's not going away. She's never going away.
I don't see the possibility myself of running for office, but I want to stay involved and work as hard as I can.
You're not going to say never, though, are you?
I never say never.
I didn't think so.
Did you hear that Southern drawl? That's why it's 2020, and Hillary Clinton has another documentary about her. I'm sure yet another book is coming soon. It's why she still goes on speaking tours and why she continues to weigh in on every possible issue and making the 2020 Democratic primary contest about her.
What Joe's victories on Super Tuesday showed is that he is building the kind of coalition that I had, basically. It's a broad-based coalition. I finished, you know, most of the work I needed to do for the nomination on Super Tuesday, and then it kind of lingered on. And I think Joe is on track to doing exactly the same thing, putting together a coalition of voters who are energized.
So that means Joe Biden's gonna go lose the election and then go to blame it on Russia.
Okey-dokey, artichokey.
It's a sad truth to hear, but it was quickly apparent that the Hulu documentary is just a prelude to whatever Hillary has planned next. I, for one, do not want to see season two. Now, that doesn't mean that I have any suicidal thoughts, because for the record, it must show that I have zero suicidal thoughts. Until next time, stay healthy and alive. America.